Second order derivative has another aspect, and that is related to the shape of the curve, because a curve can be either convex or concave. So we can try to relate this second order derivative and the second order condition with the convexity or concavity of the given curve, the maximum or minimum for which we are trying to calculate. So let us see how we can relate these two concepts here. Here we have a diagram in which we have a curve which is U-shaped. As you can see, the shape is U up here, and this is inverted U. If we try to compare these two diagrams, in which X is the independent variable and Y is the dependent variable. So Y is a function of X. So the diagram is telling us that we have a slope which is variable. Here it is negative, here it is zero, and here it is positive. Reverse happens here, positive, zero, and negative slopes. And this is Y as a function of X, where function is represented with G. So this is a convex diagram, and it is leading to a minimum. And this is a concave diagram, and it is leading to a maximum. So this is how maximum and minimum are related with convex and concave. Another possibility of such diagrams is that we have an increasing convex and an increasing concave. So you can see this is a convex diagram, however, it is on the whole giving an increasing trend. This is a concave diagram, however, it is on the whole giving an increasing trend. So therefore, it is known as increasing concave, and this is known as increasing convex diagram. The other two possibilities are that this is a convex diagram, however, the overall trend is declining, so it's a decreasing convex. This is a concave diagram, and on the whole it is having a negative slope, so it is a decreasing concave curve. So this is a set of four diagrams that are variants of the concave and convex diagrams, and they are increasing or decreasing given the situation. Now let us put this concept into certain terms, that f is continuous in the interval I and twice differentiable. These are the two requirements, that we have an interval in which the function is continuous and there are no gaps or discrete element is missing, and twice differentiable it is, because if we take two derivatives it will be possible. Because taking the second order derivative actually clears the situation if we have a convex diagram or a concave diagram. So f is convex on I, and f double bar x is greater than 0 for all x and in I. So if the curve is the function is convex, then the second order derivative will be positive, and if it is concave, then the second order derivative will be negative. As you know that the minimum happens when we have a convex diagram, and maximum happens when we have a concave diagram. And this is a concave diagram, this is a convex diagram. So you see all the things, they are getting in coherence, and we are making sense that maximum leads to a concave. And when we have a maximum, we have a second order derivative which is negative. When we have minimum, we have a second order derivative which is positive. Now mathematically we can do it. We have a numerical example. There is a population function, and it's a quadratic function. We take its first derivative, second derivative, and we get a convex diagram because the second order derivative is positive. And in this case, it's not just a simple convex diagram, it's an increasing convex diagram. As you can see, it's an overall increasing trend. So this is the population change, and as we can see, it's increasing rapidly. And then we take another diagram, and it is the case of wheat production. Here wheat production is plotted, and you can see it's an increasing function but at a decreasing rate. And if you look at it from the shape context, it is a concave diagram, and it's an increasing concave diagram. This is the production function y as a function of capital, that is how much of the capital is being used. And there are two possibilities of it, that is the value of A, and the value of A is considered to be either between 0 and 1 or less than 1. These are the two possibilities that we are considering. Case 1 is considered here, in which A is less than 1, and here A is greater than 1 somewhere, that is 1.5. So when we take the first order derivative and second order derivative, we get these results. This is the second order derivative, which is negative. So we will have a maximum, in other words, we will have a concave shape, and this is the possibility of that. We have a concave shape, it's an increasing concave shape. And when we have this function, the first derivative, second derivative, they will be here, and this will be the final result, which is a positive answer. So this positive answer means that we have a convex diagram, which means that we have a minimum. So here we can expect a convex diagram. It is a convex diagram. However, it is a convex diagram which is increasing, and it is also in lines with the concept of convexity. You see that we have tried to link the minimum and maximum with the concept of convexity and concavity, and they are able to make sense of the economic situations as well as the mathematical situations. So this is how we can connect the second order derivatives with the concept of concavity and convexity of a given function, and hence its curve. Thank you.